In continuation to the yesterday's topic, as we have learned about the anatomy of the different parts of the digestive tract, and also we have learned in this topic the different layers of the alimentary canal, and also what are the modifications that are undergone by the different cells, different parts of the alimentary canal in the gas, in the stomach as well as in the small intestine like villi, and what is the use of villi. Today we are going to talk about the digestive glands. So here already we have discussed that digestive system. Digestive system is modified at different places, and digestive system is a composition of alimentary canal plus its glands and associated glands. This is the what the digestive system is. Now, digestive glands. Gland means a group of cells or tissues. So here we need to think about the gland. Gland functionality is production of certain requirements for the digestion, and which are generally made up of cells and which are modified. So gland is a functional and structural unit where cells or tissues in that organ is modified, that is changed into a perform one or more than one function. Functional and structural unit where cells or tissues are tissues in that organ is modified into perform one or more than one functions, and generally these glands are modified columnar epithelial glandular cells. So the main composition of these glands will be columnar epithelial glandular cells, and there can be simple epithelial cells also sometimes. So this is the main composition of the. So what are the different types of glands present in our body? So your digestive, we are only talking about digestive glands. So your digestive glands are generally in our body three types. Means they will be located outside the body. Most of them are exocrine. We'll talk what is exocrine, what is endocrine. So first one are salivary glands. Second one is liver. Third one is pancreas. Fourth one is gastric glands, The fifth one is mucosal cells. Mucosal cells. So, we'll now talk about the salivary glands. First one, salivary glands. There are three pairs of salivary glands. The first one are parotid glands. The number is 2 and they are located in the just below the ear pinna, near to each ear in cheek region ear. The second one are called as submaxillary or submandibular. They are located at the angles of lower jaw, that is here. In the angles of the lower jaw, and they will be pouring the secretions into the vestibule of the mouth, oral cavity, that is vestibule of mouth. The third one are sublingual and they are present below the tongue. All these are two member, that is three pairs, pair means one step. So these are the glands and they pour their secretions. They all together will produce saliva. They all together produce saliva. So what is the composition of this saliva? What is the composition of saliva? Saliva is a liquid substance with water approximately to 90% water is present in that, plus salts are present in that. Enzymes are present in that. Mucin is present in it. And lysozyme is present in it. So what are the salts? They can be sodium, potassium, calcium, and so on. These are some of the chlorine, etc. So the enzymes present in the saliva are ptyalin and salivary amylase. Mucin is also present in this, which is sticky in nature, and the function of this is antibacterial in nature. So it is an antibacterial agent, and generally saliva maintains the pH of 6.8 to 7.2. So it is slightly acidic to basic, mostly slightly based on the food, slightly basic and acidic in nature. So this is the very important composition, generally important for me point of view. They can ask any sort of question from this. Many times I have seen the question related to the lysozyme or the enzymes present in the saliva. Most of the times the main question was that. So the next one of the glands of the digestive system is the largest gland in the human body, called as liver. Liver is a approximately 1.2 to 1.5 kg organ in the human body, and it is having two lobes means one lobe, two lobes. So it is made up of two lobes. It is made up of two lobes. Location of the liver, it is just below the abdominal, just below the abdominal cavity it is present, and the each lobe consists of hepatic lobules, consist of these hepatic lobules consist of hepatocytes and Kupffer cells. Hepatocytes are Kupffer cells. These hepatic lobules are the structural and functional units of this hepatic lobules of the structural and functional units of liver. This Kupffer cells helps in phagocytosis. digestion of extracellular material. It is the main function, and hepatocytes will produce bile juice. Bile juice. And whatever the hepatocytes are, the other name of hepatocytes is called as hepatocells. This bile juice is carried by bile duct, for digestion process. And approximately 72 functions are performed by liver. Approximately 72 functions. So the some of the very few important functions is conversion of blood cells into pigments, that is bilirubin and bilirubin, intoxication of drugs, that is also done by the liver, testing food quality and assurance, phagocytosis. So these are the some of the functions done by the liver. And whatever the functions, so the bile juice is produced in liver but concentrated means becoming thicker, dilute to concentrate. Dilution means water containing high amount. Concentrating means removal of water content, mostly water content. So this is done in gall bladder. Note these points first. Next one, pancreas. Pancreas is also, it is both glands are present. One is digestive gland are present, and endocrine gland is present. So So it is called vagus tube gland, means it is present on the outside. It is called exocrine gland, and it is endocrine gland. So for that reason, the pancreas is also called as mixed gland or dual gland or endocrine or exocrine gland.
It is a mixed gland, dual gland, exocrine or endocrine gland.
The outer part, exo means outer gland, also called as digestive gland, produces pancreatic juice. The outer part produces pancreatic juice. The endocrine gland or the inner gland, endocrine, produces insulin, glucagon and somatostatin. These are the three hormones. These are produced by the endocrine gland. Insulin is produced by alpha cells, and glucagon is produced by beta cells, and somatostatin by gamma cells or delta cells. So this pancreatic juice is generally alkaline in nature. Alkaline means pH is greater than 7.1. is slightly alkaline in nature. It also consists of enzymes. The pancreatic juice also consists of enzymes present in it, and these enzymes are responsible for the digestion. So this pancreas can consist of pancreatic juice. Composition is trypsin, chymotrypsin, pepsinogen, lipases, amylases, sucrases, maltases, and so on. So this is the primary composition of pancreatic juice.